I'd been living in London for about 7 years and always felt intensely South African. I always wanted to return home. And the moment that triggered it for me was when we were, all of us freezing cold South Africans, came to listen to Madiba speak at the embassy in London. And there he stood over this whole crowd of us freezing cold South Africans and he said, "I love you all so much, I want to put you in my pocket and take you home." And the crowd just looked around and went mad, and I looked around going, "Well, what on earth are we doing here?"
In 2003, Johannesburg advertising agency Morris Jones created the Homecoming Revolution brand.
I came home and saw all the opportunities and everything that was possible. And the idea of being able to say to people, "You're not a failure if you return home. You're a pioneer, you're an entrepreneur, you're a revolutionary."
And so started the first of many successful events around the world, where South African expats could gather together to hear about home. London became a key destination for major expos, with over 50 blue-chip South African companies and organizations showcasing jobs, careers, property, investments, and entrepreneurial opportunities.
Returning people who say, "Oh, I don't know if I should come home, there are no jobs." We say, "Well, don't say there are no jobs, come home and create the jobs."
The call to returnees to come home and open a business was a key message, and workshops were held abroad to showcase all the entrepreneurial opportunities in different sectors.
You've got a catchphrase where we say, "Don't waste the good crisis."
36% of the successful entrepreneurs were those who were homecomers.
Living abroad helped me become a better entrepreneur.
You need to be, you know, be dogged and determined.
When you're told no 25 times, you know, having that tenacity to get up and take that second, that 26th punch.
They come home, they feel a sense of purpose, they want to make a difference, they've got their international expertise and their global relationships.
We are looking to expand heavily into Africa, into West and Eastern Africa.
You can be focused and dedicated on building a business, but all the byproducts of that is a contribution to community.
Ultimately, I look to mentor as many people starting their own businesses.
We do outreach programs. It's the biggest outreach program in South Africa.
Early childhood development, early childhood education is an area that we have ignored.
Hopefully create the next Springbok out of that, the next Protea cricket player, etc.
Increasing access to quality healthcare for people not only in South Africa, but in Africa more broadly.
For every one skilled person that returns, 9 new jobs are created.
The Homecoming Revolution has hosted over 30 international events, from Dubai to Washington, from Sydney to the Netherlands, from Dublin to Chicago, and had face-to-face engagement with over 15,000 South Africans abroad. High-profile individuals were also a key ingredient for garnering attention. And when Rake Nietling returned to South Africa, he became a Homecoming Revolution brand ambassador.
We need young, energetic, skilled South Africans.
Other famous speakers included Cheryl Carolus, Danny Jordan, Professor Barney Pityan, Trevor Noah, Gwede Mandashe, Nick Benedil, Helen Ziller, Rolf Meyer, Sonia Sibota, Cheryl Delore, Benjamin Zander, and Aaron Mugwena.
Through my participation in the movie Searching for Sugar Man, I hope that we are bringing South Africa a lot of recognition.
South Africans all over the world receive bi-monthly newsletters on relevant developments and opportunities, and the website offers a personalized service and expert advice that includes making the move, settling in, finding schools, financial and legal matters, and getting connected.
And the Homecoming Revolution brings that all together, you know, for people who are going through this, by people who've already gone through that.
Like Angel Jones and Marina Smithers of the Homecoming Revolution.
Since its inception, the Homecoming Revolution brand has enjoyed global media coverage and been the opinion leader on skills repatriation in South Africa. Homecoming Revolution has had over 1 million unique visitors to its website. And best of all, South Africa's brain drain retention ranking has dramatically improved in the Global Competitiveness Report.
And people often ask me, you know, "What's the most important thing you learned at Harvard?" And I tell them, "I learned how much I love Africa."
Young people should have wings, but they also should have roots.
It's very exciting to start planning the rest of my life.
My kids will grow up with their cousins and with their grandparents.
On returning to South Africa, you return to open arms.
Abroad, we can make new friends, but we can't make old friends.
To know that we had a role in their return is something that resonates very deeply with me.
Swimming lessons, yeah, playing outside, jumping on your trampoline, taking your dog for a walk,
riding a bicycle on the road.
And now on the eve of our 10-year anniversary, we're hoping to roll out quite quickly onto the rest of the African continent and in fact help to inspire Nigerians and Ghanaians and Kenyans and Ugandans in the wider diaspora to actually return home. And the way we'd love to do that is by finding country champions in each city who have returned home themselves and helping to tell all the stories of those who have returned home, because after all that's what inspires people abroad to come home. So we'd love to create this Africa-wide one-stop-shop platform where businesses partner with us to showcase all the job opportunities, entrepreneurial opportunities, property, products and services back on the continent, and to collaborate with as many like-minded diaspora groups as possible. There's this beautiful African saying that if you want to go quickly, go alone, but if you want to go far, go together.